There are a plethora of 55 plus retirement communities here in the Phoenix Valley. My goal in this video is to break down the best of these communities for you to make the decision for yourself. We'll go through each price range because I know everyone's in a different scenario, and then I'll let you decide which one is going to work for you the best. And stay tuned for the end because there is one retirement community that you have to stay away from. I am Trev Talks and we are starting right now. We're going to start with the lowest priced, but also the best lowest price retirement community in the Phoenix Valley is going to be Sun City. This is the original retirement community. It is actually the largest and it is a city of itself located right between Glendale and Surprise. It is by far the largest retirement community and it is also going to be the cheapest, with the median home sale being $285 in the last 90 days. And their rec facility fee is going to be $496, and this is going to include all the things you need: racquetball, swimming pools, fitness center, indoor walking track, pickleball courts, tennis, you name it. They also have an extra fee with golf, and this is by far the best rate we are going to see when it comes to golf rates. And you get to play 8 different courses. Some of those are executive courses. 8 different courses across Sun City for $1,550 a person. You could be playing that as much as you want, as far as I know, and that would be about $130 monthly, and you could be playing any of those 8 courses. They also have a bowling alley with tournaments happening and games under $3, and I think you can also get some sort of annual pass there to save some money. And lastly, along with this community, they have a $3,500 transfer fee if it is your first time. This is actually a thing called a preservation fee. This is something you should know up front. And that is a kind of a steep cost if it is your first time coming into the community. But the purpose of it is to upkeep the area, so keep it preserved. And also it removes investors from coming into that area and either flipping homes or renting it out. It's unlikely that an investor is willing to pay that much money up front. So it helps not only preserve the area and its kind of niceness, but also remove the idea of investors coming in and messing up some parts of the land. Now, the second cheapest retirement community in the Phoenix Valley is going to be Sun City West. This is obviously a sister community to Sun City, but it's going to be a little bit nicer and newer community. So Sun City, the original one, was built in the 60s and 70s, and you'll notice that driving around. That's the style of houses, where Sun City West is closer to the 80s. Price ranges there, the median home sale in the last 90 days is going to be about $360,000, and their rec center fees are $497 per person, whereas Sun City was $497 for 2 people. This is going to be $497 per person. They do have 7 golf courses here. 3 of those are executive. Their fee is going to be a little bit more, $3,500 for unlimited play. And then they're also going to have a $1,250 for unlimited twilight play if you are trying to save some money there and play in the afternoons. But I will warn you, afternoon golf in the summer in Arizona is not the best idea. Every other season it's not going to be bad, but over summer you probably are not going to be wanting to play past about 10 o'clock in the morning. There's going to be a link below for their rates right there. They also have a huge private library. They have a bowling center just like the regular Sun City. They have 4 rec centers with everything you can imagine, all the great things to do. They also have 100 plus chartered clubs, from auto restoration to art, ceramics, and many more. They got a lot of clubs to do there. So this is a very active and nice community, a little bit further separated away from the city, almost above Surprise is Sun City West. And they're also gonna have constant events going on, like jazz night, movie marathons, movies at the pool, concerts, scavenger hunts, all that great stuff. And they have also that $3,500 asset preservation fee. So that is, again, just to remove investors and to keep the area nice like it should. Next on our list is going to be Cantamia of Estrella. This is going to be in Goodyear, all the way down at the bottom of Goodyear. This is going to be a very secluded community, but it is also a very nice community. So median sale price was $347,000 in this price range. And so that's going to be about middle of the pack when it comes to retirement communities, about $350,000. That's a pretty decent price for retirement communities. There's a total of $250 monthly HOA fees to live here. Along with this, you're going to have a lake in the middle. You're going to have mountain views. It is a very secluded, like I said, and they're going to have all these great things along with their village center. So they have lap pools, a spa, workout facilities, yoga studio, cafe, and wine bar. They have everything to do at that Village Center. It's 29,000 square feet with a lake. It's got a resort style indoor and outdoor heated pool with fire pits. That lake is stocked with fish, so you can go in there and do some catch and release there. Also have a dog park, pickleball, bocce ball, tennis courts, hiking, and plenty of things to do. This is gonna be a little bit more of a desert feel. I mean, everywhere in Phoenix area is gonna be deserty, but this especially, you're gonna be up against the mountains. Very secluded, I cannot say that enough. You are up against the mountains at the foothills there. So this is gonna have a very mountainy kind of hiking type of feel. And there is no golf course in this community, but the Estrella Golf Club is very close. They have their own annual pass that you can look into, so check that out, but it is unrelated to the community. So we've gone through under 300,000, which is gonna be Sun City, and then we had two in the 300,000s, and now we've gotten to the 400,000 price range, and the first one's gonna be Trilogy at Power Ranch, located in Gilbert, Arizona. So this is over in the East Valley. The others so far have been on the West Valley, so if you're looking in the East Valley, this is gonna be a great option for you, especially in that 400,000 price range, with the median sale price going for 459 in the last 90 days. They have a 459 also, so 459 price and 459 HOA fee quarterly, and that's going to include access to their clubhouse and all their great facilities. They have two swimming pools and a spa, all the great things like bocce ball, horseshoes, pickleball, tennis courts, everything you're looking for there. They have a fitness center, a cafe, arts and crafts. They got everything you can imagine at this clubhouse. They do have a golf course there, but there is no annual passes. You can get a member card for about $175, which is gonna give you some discounted rates. So there are no unlimited play cards that I was able to see, but they do have that card, which can get you some discounted rates. I will show that picture here so you can see what those rates are going to be. Another one in this 400,000 range is gonna be Pebble Creek, which is gonna be back in the West Valley. So this is gonna be right above the 10 and right east of the 303, right next to Litchfield Park. You're gonna have really good access to the freeway. So if you did still wanna be in a retirement community but have good access to downtown Phoenix and Scottsdale, this is a great place for you. Median sale price in the last 90 days is about 460,000. And there are a decent amount going under 400,000, so it is possible to be in that 300,000 range at Pebble Creek. Their HOA fees are $2,728 annually, which is a decent price. That's a little steep, but it does include access to their clubhouse, which has a library, billiards, and a really nice Renaissance theater there. They also have a large fitness center with aquatics and indoor and outdoor pools and plenty of racket sports and racket courts to go along there. So there are a lot of things to do, and they have tons of fitness classes. They do have a golf course. It's about $4,000 to play unlimited, or if you didn't want to go with that unlimited play, if you are a resident of the area, you do get about $20 off per round, making it around $60 per round in peak seasons, which is really good. $60 of golf out here in Phoenix in the peak season, so kind of the winter and spring months, is a really great rate, especially for a nice course. They also have tons of social clubs, including art, community events, educational programs, service opportunities, and plenty more. Again, this is the Pebble Creek community. So we've gone through the 400,000 price range, and now we're gonna get to the upper echelon at that 500,000 price range. And the first one we are going to look at is the Victory at Ferrado. This is extremely West Valley over in Buckeye, so a little bit closer to California if you're just kind of looking on a map. And it is a little bit out there, and Ferrado itself is sort of separated from all the other communities, but the unique part about this retirement community is that there is the retirement community itself, but right next to it is the regular community, I guess, the non-retirement community, so where anyone can live. So you are not very secluded over here. Ferrado itself is secluded, but you do have the other friends and family that can live nearby if they are not able to live in a retirement community. This is a great spot if your family does live in Buckeye or Ferrado itself, because you're gonna be closer to them. The median home sale is gonna be $561,000, and this place is new. To understand that price a little bit more, it was built in 2019, so this is a very new community. You'll probably see signs, if you're coming from California, of the Ferrado new builds that are happening. So their HOA is $226 monthly, and that includes all the great necessities. So you have the resort pools, fitness center, yoga studio, racket sports pavilion, sports den, and plenty more. And with things to do, they actually have their own Main Street. So there is the Verado Main Street with great restaurants and shops there. It's kind of a fun afternoon thing you get to do over there. They have parks and mountain trails. You're right along some foothills over there, so some great scenery. And they have their own swim parts to take the kids or the grandchildren. And then they also have two golf courses created by PGA star Tom Lehman. And their price is going to be more expensive than the others because these courses are very new and created by a PGA star. So they're going to come in at about $6,200 for unlimited play there. And again, that's kind of more understood when you see how nice these courses are. And again, this is just really a good spot for those who are wanting to be farther out in the West Valley over in Buckeye. Just because it is very secluded, it's not close to downtown Phoenix whatsoever. It's probably gonna be at least a 30-minute drive to get over there, if not more. Now we're gonna get to our final two really high-end retirement communities in the Phoenix area. And the first one is gonna be Trilogy at Distancia. This is located in northern Peoria, way up top in northern Peoria, in the foothills of the mountains there. This is a very secluded community. This is in the Vistancia community. There are four sections of Vistancia. They kind of have like a family friendly, they have a retirement community, and then they just have two regular communities where anyone can stay. And this is a very secluded, very exclusive community. So it is very difficult to find a home there. Most of them are over 500,000. I don't know if you're finding one under 500,000 right now, because it is highly desired and they have everything you can imagine up there. So you have an HOA fee of $777 quarterly, and this is gonna include access to their resort clubs. They have 45,000 square feet of their main center there, and I think that is the largest one we will see. You have great food with views of the mountains. They have their own spa and two resort pools, so they have a ton to do up there. They have a championship golf course, and the fees for that one are around $3,000, and then you also have to pay $1,875 for a cart fee. They have different prices that you can look at. I'll show it up on the screen here so you can see. And there are different prices, like if you only want to pay for like 60 rounds for the whole year, you can kind of get a discounted right there. But this is extremely high-end course and community. They have tons of stuff to do. They have an artisan studio for art classes. They have culinary classes. They have two fitness centers. They have a backyard grill, which is great for a cocktail hour. They have parties on their event lawn. They have a tap room. They got dozens of clubs you can join, from things like pickleball to bocce ball, all that great stuff. They have hiking clubs. There's tons of different clubs just for this Vistancia community. This is easily considered the highest end retirement community in the West Valley. And next we will get into the highest of the East Valley, which is going to be Rio Verde at Fountain Hills. This is way over near Fountain Hills. This is east of Scottsdale, so even outside the valley, I believe, because it is in its own area. This is a very secluded community. You have mountain views surrounded you. You're very close to the Fountain Park, which is a super cool fountain that shoots extremely high in the air. Large grass area, great kind of walking trail right there. The Fountain Hills community is very high end. It is very secluded from the rest of the city, so if you don't want to have to deal with traffic or being anywhere near all the hustle and bustle in the city, this is a great community. And as you're going to see, it is also a very high-end community. The median home sale was $542,000 in the last 90 days, and their HOA fee is $4,500 yearly. And this is why I put this at the highest end of all the retirement communities, because their HOA is so expensive, but you do get access to some great things. I'm gonna list those off, it is a ton. You have all the community facilities like the swimming pool, tennis courts, pickleball courts, fitness center. They have a library, they have art rooms, exercise classes. Included in this HOA is gonna be your garbage and trash pickup, and you're gonna get some basic cable so that you get the free TV as you're gonna move in there. So this is a very high-end community with some things provided in that HOA. As far as the golf course goes, this is a very high-end country club. And they did not specify all the prices. I had to go and sign up for myself, basically. And since I was not in a situation to be signing up for this country club, I didn't get all the info. It sounded like the initiation fee itself was at least $10,000. It could be more than that. And then the dues being around $700 monthly for that golf course. And I think a lot of great things are included in that, so we can kind of justify that price a little bit more. You are gonna get access to some PGA instructors and you're going to get free instruction from these people. The golf courses are world-class and extremely private. There's probably going to be some famous people golfing at these places because this is such a high-end community. And again, this area itself has just some awesome views of the mountains, and the nights there are incredible. You get some really cool sunsets. I cannot recommend Fountain Hills itself, even if you're not going for this retirement community. Fountain Hills is a really neat area and very secluded from the rest of the city if you want a kind of quieter space. Now, what you have all been waiting for is the 155 plus community that you absolutely should not be moving into. This is my opinion, but the Mirabella at ASU. I do not know what anyone was thinking, but they put a 55 plus retirement community, as you can tell, on the campus of ASU, right on the corner of Mill Ave. And Mill Avenue, if you do not know, is a really big party street. And for some reason, people thought that a retirement community right on the corner of one of the biggest party campuses in the nation was a good idea. And so what do you expect is happening? There are tons and tons of complaints from the people living at Mirabella that the college campus is too loud. There is too much going on. Well, of course, because most retirement people kind of want a peaceful lifestyle. They want to enjoy things. They want to do outdoor activities without the distraction of some crazy college students all around them. And well, that's the exact opposite of what they decided to do. The neat thing is that it is a really cool high-rise building with some cool amenities, but most retired people are not looking to live in a downtown area. If you are, this is a great place for you. But from my experience, most retired people want to enjoy that kind of secluded area where you can also have access to some fun things to do, but you get a quiet, peaceful lifestyle, and the Mirabella ASU is not that at all. I would definitely not recommend choosing this as a location to retire if you are wanting that quiet, fun lifestyle. My name is Trevor Bragg. I'm a real estate agent here in the Phoenix Valley. If you are looking into one of these retirement communities or have some questions about other ones and if I recommend them, feel free to reach out. My number will be on the screen or in the description below. Again, I'm a real estate agent, so I can answer your questions, or if you're looking to buy or sell a home in these communities, feel free to reach out to me also, and I can help you out there. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.